अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, द चैप्टर टुडे आई शैल डिस्कस, दिस चैप्टर इज फ्रॉम योर मॉडल स्टडीज बुक, दैट इज सदका एंड ज़कात। बिफोर गोइंग टू द ऑब्लिगेटरी एक्ट दैट इज ज़कात, वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट सदका। जनरली वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट सदका, वी ऑफन लिसन टू दिस वर्ड सदका। वेन एवर वी पास रमजान, मंथ ऑफ रमजान, एट दैट टाइम मेनी पीपल, मेनी आवर नेबर्स, मेनी ऑफ आवर रिलेटिव्स, आवर पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो, दे ऑल्सो गिव द सदका। इट इज़ वेरी मच प्रीवेलेंट इन आवर लोकेलिटी अमंग द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी, सदका। जनरली वेन एवर दिस टर्म कम्स बिफोर आवर आइज और कम्स टू आवर माइंड, एट दैट टाइम वी थिंक दैट सदका इज चैरिटी, लिटरली चैरिटी। इफ वी गिव एनीथिंग टू एनी वन, for example if I give an amount of rice, if I give a piece of bread to a needy person, if I give an amount of money to any person, anything given for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is sadqa. But in Islam it means every good deeds paid to a person is called sadqa. For example, if a person going somewhere, he is unable to lift his burden. For example, he is holding a very weightful bag, he is unable to lift it, you are helping him, you are giving sadqa, you are paying your labor. Any kind of, for example, if a person is passing through you, you are giving salam, that means salam, what does it mean? May peace be upon you. That means you are praying for him, it is also a kind of sadqa. You are smiling at someone, looking at some one of your known persons, smiling at him, you are paying your salam. It is also, smiling is also a kind of sadqa. That means every good deed paid to a person to make him happy, make him comfortable, to let him be in a comfortable position, this is called sadqa. But zakat has some, and difference between sadqa and zakat is zakat has some limit, sadqa doesn't have any limit. If you go through the stories of prophets and his companions, many companions were there who spent their whole wealth in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who helped their brothers whenever they were in need, they gave everything to them whenever the necessity arised, whenever necessity came. At that time, some of the companions of prophet, they gave all their wealth, some gave half of their wealth. So this type of things, whenever you pay something, maybe it is labor, maybe it is smile, maybe it is a kind of help, maybe it is money, maybe it is a thing or good, all these are sadqa. And difference between sadqa and zakat, basic difference is sadqa is optional, zakat is mandatory. Sadqa is optional, zakat is mandatory. If I do not give sadqa, I may not get the virtues, but I can't be a sinful person. I can't be a sinful person if I don't pay sadqa. But if I don't pay zakat, I will be a sinful person, and Islamic country may compel me to give this zakat. Now let's discuss about this zakat. So what does it mean, zakat? The term zakat, it means to purify something. That means zakat we give from our wealth. Zakat often we give from our wealth. That means by giving this zakat, we purify our wealth. Actually, whatever we earn, all these are not our earning. Allah has given us the opportunity, Allah has given us the capability to earn this, that is why we are earning. If Allah had not given this opportunity, we would not have earned that. Remember this thing. That is why we must pay thanks to Him. And merely verbal thanking is not enough. Sometimes we are to give something from our wealth, whatever is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes by earning much wealth, sometimes our arrogance also may arise. Our arrogance may arise, pride may arise. Different kinds of things of different kinds of feelings arise. At that time, what should we do? We are prescribed to give a certain amount of wealth from this earned wealth to the poor people, to the needy people. And whenever we pay this certain amount of wealth, at that time our wealth becomes completely purified. Okay. And zakat, remember this thing, zakat is completely related to heart. That means whenever we give zakat, if anyone feels that he is earning, whatever he earned, it is his own creation, automatically a kind of feelings, a sense of arrogance will arise in his mind. A sense of pride will arise in his mind. But whenever he thinks that I am earning, but it is not my earning. Allah has given me the opportunity to earn this, that is why I am earning. Actually, this wealth is for Allah, is of Allah. If he actually thinks that, whenever he thinks that, at that time his sense of arrogance will go. And if he thinks that if it is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, an amount of this Allah's amount, from this amount of this Allah's amount, I have to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at that time collecting an amount of money, an amount of wealth he will give, automatically his arrogance will be vanished from his heart. His heart will be purified. His money will be, his wealth will be purified. Along with that, his heart will also be purified. That is why this type of giving, this type of charity is called as zakat, which means to purify. Okay. And zakat is not very much mandatory, and this is so much important that it is not related to tax. Tax, that means you are prescribed to give something. Government will prescribe you to give something. You are to give. After giving this, no purification of mind will come. But you pay, you give charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the satisfaction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I guarantee you a sense of relief, a sense of calmness, a sense of peace will come in your mind. Whenever you help someone, any kind of helping, maybe zakat, may not be zakat, a sense of peace will come from your mind if you help anyone. If it does not come to your mind, then automatically I may say that you are not a perfect Muslim. If after giving money your mind will say ish, what I have given, sense of regret, if the sense of regret comes, then it will not be, you are not a complete Muslim. A real Muslim, whenever he does a righteous deeds, at that time for this righteous deeds a sense of satisfaction will come in his mind. So zakat is somehow related to this. It purifies your mind, it purifies your heart, it purifies your wealth. Tax does not do it. That is why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, they preferred zakat so much. During the time of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after the wafat of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after his passing away, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu became the first Khalifa. You know it. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, at that time, one of the tribes, different tribes were there in Saudi Arabia. You may know that. Different tribes were there. So, from these tribes, one tribe which was Muslim, they embraced Islam. They were performing Salat. But despite all these good deeds, they did not want to give zakat. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was very cool person, he was very balanced person. Despite all their righteous deeds, he became very much angry and he declared war against them. And he said, if the same thing happened during the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I would have done that. So this is zakat. If a wealthy person, he does not pay zakat properly, the Islamic country, the authority of Islamic country has the full right to declare war against them. If a community does not give zakat, a community of wealthy people does not give zakat, the Islamic country has the full right to declare war against them. If a person does not give zakat, the Islamic country has the full authority, full right to arrest them and punish them. This much important zakat is. Remember this thing. Right after the death of the people who came before us, the generation of people, right after came before us, or right after the death of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the generation of people which were alive, which was alive. These people, this generation of people was, that means very righteous they were. They were very much righteous. But despite all these things, they were righteous, their righteousness were not, that means purely valid. Their righteousness, full, all rest of their works were not accepted. Abu Bakr Siddiq, the first Khalifa, declared war against them. This much important zakat was. And in hadith it is mentioned, that in Quran it is mentioned that those who do not give charity, or those who do not pay zakat, on the day of judgment, all their belongings, all their wealth will be melted in fire. And afterwards, their backs will be branded. That means a seal will be given on their back. And in another hadith, it is said that the person who does not give zakat, his all wealth will become a poisonous snake, and it will encircle his neck, and it will be biting him. That means all his wealth, whatever he created, whatever he earned, he created not actually, God Almighty has given him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. On the day of judgment, if he does not pay zakat on the day of judgment, what will happen? This all wealth will become poisonous snake, and it will encircle his neck, and it will be biting them. This much. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once asked another Muslim. He was a wealthy person. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "Do you give zakat?" He replied in negative, and afterwards Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if he does not do so, on the day of judgment, he will be worn a bracelet of fire. He will be compelled to wear a bracelet of fire. For which thing? Now let's come to this question. For which thing we are to give zakat? In Islam it is said that zakat should be given for gold, silver and financial assets. Whatever financial assets are there. For example, for this podium, if I have a podium or table or chair like this at my home, should I give zakat for this? No. Because its value will be decreased. Day by day, its value will be decreased. But if I keep gold, its value will not be decreased. Its value will be increased day by day. More you wear it, more its value will be increased. Gold, silver and financial assets. Whatever financial assets, for example, in the form of money, in the form of rupees, whatever financial assets are there, you have to pay zakat for this. Merchandise, for example, some goods we keep for at our godown, for selling, for buying, for selling specially. For this we have to give. Agricultural products, this is called ushur actually. Agricultural products also, for agricultural products, we have to give zakat, an amount of livestock, camel, cattle, sheep, goats, for this we have to give zakat also. Minerals and treasure trove, for minerals also, we have to give zakat. And how much? What is the nisab? What is the certain amount of money, which stays at your hand, in your hand, and for which we have to give zakat? What is the amount of money for which we are to give zakat? In one sentence we can say. Amount of money or amount of wealth. In Islam it is said that means it is annually zakat. For example, salat we perform 5 times in a day. Whenever Ramadan arrives, at that time 3 days in a month we keep fast. And zakat once in a year, and most of the Muslim people in our locality at least, they give zakat in the month of Ramadan, especially on 27th Ramadan they give. It is actually not mandatory, but it will be better, because in the month of Ramadan your virtuous deeds are multiplied. Whatever virtuous deed you will do, everything will be multiplied. So that is why most of the people give zakat in the month of Ramadan. So what is the amount of wealth for which we have to give zakat? The amount of minimum scale of gold, that means 85 grams, and silver is 595 grams. If this much, what is the price of 85 grams gold? For example, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh, 4 lakh, whatever, 50,000, 10,000, whatever. If you have the amount equal to 85 grams gold or 595 grams silver, if you have, once again I am saying, if you have the amount which is equal to 85 grams gold or 595 grams silver, then you are to pay zakat for your amount. Then you are to pay 2.5% of this amount. If your amount is equal to or more than 85 grams, I have forgotten to say more than, if your amount is equal to 85 grams gold or 595 grams silver, equal to or more than 85 grams gold or 595 grams silver, then you are to pay zakat for this. That means how much amount? 2.5% of this amount. Whatever amount you have, for example, you have the amount of 235 grams gold. Many people are millionaire. They may have this amount. So if they have, or if you have, or you, if I have 230 grams of gold, an amount which is equal to 230 grams of gold, then I have to pay 2.5% of this amount. Okay. For merchandise, that means whatever golds, whatever silver we we give for 1 year in our godown, for this we have to give zakat. And for agricultural product, I have said already, 2.5, not 10%, you have to pay. Okay, 10%, that means, for example, if your crops are rain fed, that means you need not pay any labor for these crops. For example, jackfruit, mango, all these are coming without paying any labor. At your home, one mango tree is there, one jackfruit tree is there. This many trees, many things are there. Sometimes betel nut are also there, betel nuts. Many things are there. We need not pay any labor for this. Directly, if we get this agricultural product, we are to pay 10% for this. 10% of whole agricultural products, whatever we collect in a year. Okay. If, for example, if I collect 10 bags of mango in a year, I have to pay at least one bag. I have to give at least one bag. Like this, if you pay labor for any crops, okay, if you pay labor for any crops and you are earning these crops, for this we are to earn 5%. If I irrigate these crops, if by paying labor I am earning these crops, agricultural product, for this I have to give 5%. Okay. And another thing is that if a person, for example, I have 1 lakh rupee, I have 20,000 rupee, I have 50,000 rupee, but I have a family to feed. Many people are there at my family. Then what to do? Then first of all, I have to feed them. It is my prime responsibility. And if my amount is saved, and if 1 year is crossed, then I have to give. If my debt is there, if I am in loan, then first of all, I have to recover my loan, then I have to pay the zakat, otherwise not. Remember this thing. And which people are entitled to give zakat? In Quran, it is mentioned 8 categories of people. They are entitled, they may take zakat. Understood? They may take zakat, rest others not. Only 8 categories of people, it is mentioned in Quran. These 8 categories of people are, first of all, the poor people. The poor people, that means those who are considered as poor, they can take zakat. The destitute and needy, that means some poor people are there, they may not stretch hand for getting help. For their self-respect, they may not go to you for begging. They cannot beg. They are called as miskin. They can take zakat. Sometimes they have this much self-respect, they cannot, that means after taking, I have personal experience, that means after giving zakat also they do not take zakat. That means they say, we cannot take zakat. We are not that much needy. But they are needy in actual. Actually, they are needy, but they are not disclosing their condition, financial condition. This much self-respect they have. So you can pay zakat to these people. Officials entrusted with the collection and administration of zakat funds. That means in an Islamic country, finance department will be there and zakat will be collected by Islamic government. Okay. And some people will be counting, some people will be distributing, this accounts will be managed by some person. The whole zakat fund will be managed by some person and they have to be given some salary. So from zakat fund you can give them the salary. Okay. The people who are assigned to manage the zakat fund, they may get their salary from zakat fund. Okay. And those whose hearts are to be won over, Muslim converts are usually included in this category. Remember this thing. For example, right after the conversion, for example, a non-Muslim person who is converted to Islam, who comes to Islam, right after coming to Islam, he may leave his family. His family may abandon him. Okay. He may be thrown out of his family. So right after getting thrown out, he may leave all his property also. At that time, from a person may become a poor person from a rich person. Before embracing Islam, he might be a rich person, but right after accepting Islam, as his family has thrown him out, he has become a poor person. So for winning his heart, we may give an amount of zakat to him. That is why in the month of Ramadan you may experience this thing. Many converted people nowadays, though, they do not come. Nowadays I don't have any personal experience. Many people earlier days, many people used to come after their accepting. They used to come to our mosque and they used to seek money. That we are in need, we have some money problems, as we have converted, as we have embraced Islam, that is why we need some money. And the people collecting some money, they people used to give also. So for winning their heart, we may use zakat. Okay. Ransoming of prisoners of war and freeing from bondage. For example, if war is going on between one Islamic country and one non-Islamic country, and some of the soldiers of Islamic country or some of the citizens of Islamic country, they are arrested by this non-Islamic country. For making them free, for letting them be free, we may pay an amount of zakat as ransom money. Okay. Overburdened debtors. Overburdened, the person who took loan but he is unable to repay his loan, he may take zakat. He may be given. Okay. And number 7, those who working in Allah's cause, which included every kind of righteous struggle both in war and peace. That means fi sabilillah. Those who are working in Allah's cause. For example, a person who is giving dawah to non-Muslim. A person who spreads the message of Islam. A person or a group of people or an organization, a righteous organization, which spreads the message of Islam through the heart and soul of the people. For spreading, different equipments are needed. For example, book is a kind of equipment. For example, videos are kind of equipment. YouTube videos, for making YouTube videos, all money is needed. Okay. Book, leaflet, pamphlet, walling, hoarding, postering, different things can be done for spreading the message of Islam. If you go to Hyderabad and other places, street dawah teams are there. With booklets, with mics, with video cameras, they go to common people. They going to them, they make conversation with these people. Make conversation about Islam. Do you know anything about Islam? Yes. No, I don't know. Have you ever read Quran? They give the translated version of Quran. English version of Quran, Urdu version of Quran, Hindi version of Quran, which can be read by the non-Muslim people. Some non-Muslim people can read Urdu also. This Quran, for publishing this Quran, money is required. So from zakat fund we may use this money. As this, whatever is done, it is done in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fi sabilillah. So zakat can be used for dawah purpose. any kind of, for example, a Muslim country is making war against a non-Muslim country. So for war also money is required, so zakat can be used. And travelers, the traveler who will be in need, for him we can use zakat. Okay. And remember one thing, only Muslim people are entitled to receive zakat, not non-Muslim. Okay. And some tips are there for giving this charity and zakat, for spending in the ways of Allah. In your book, some very nice tips are given. Give only to please Allah. Remember this thing. Many people I have experienced in my life, in my small phase of life, in my small term of life, not small time, it is a big term also I consider. In my, they give charity, they do charitable works, different charitable works they often do. But fact is that they want to exhibit their works, righteous deeds. What is the necessity of this? On the day of judgment, whenever you will go before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you what you have done. What you have done in your worldly life. You will say, sir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have done this, I have done charitable works. Allah will say, if Allah asks you, then you have done charitable works for the reason of getting praised. For the reason of getting praised, then what will happen? And you have got praised, then whatever you needed, you already got in world. Then for hereafter, nothing has remained for you. So that is why nothing has remained, then you are to go to Jahannam. And if you do charitable works for the satisfaction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the day of judgment, if you reply that I have done this thing, for your satisfaction, then Allah will be satisfied and He will give you barju and He will send you to Jannat. So for satisfying Allah, only to please Allah, we are to do our works. Otherwise, whatever righteous deeds we will do, all these will go in vain. Number two, give only good things. It is the nature of some people. It is also a kind of nature of some people that whenever they give charity, whenever they do charity, whenever they give money, whenever they give any goods, clothes, whatever, that means spoiled things they give. In Quran it is mentioned, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will not become a perfect Muslim, you will not get the perfect reward until you give those things which are preferred by yourself, which you prefer for yourself, which you like the most. You will not, once again I am saying, you will not be a perfect Muslim unless you give those things in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what you prefer for yourself. In Surah Al Imran, it is given. So whenever we will do this thing, whenever we will give anything, we should choose the best thing. We are giving an apple, a mango, the mango which is the best among all the mangoes. We are to give away this mango. Understood? We are giving a cloth, not the torn cloth we are to give. We are to give the best cloth, the well-furnished cloth we are to give. Number three, if we are doing charity, we should not hurt anyone. He is in need. It does not mean that you are to hurt him. You are to give charity, but along with that, we cannot hurt him. With smiling face, with good behavior, we are to pay. Give to the deserving. We are to give the deserving person, the person who deserves to get help. For him, we are to give. And one thing also we are to look after, we are to consider that sometimes we give charity. Some small kids roam here and there and they seek money. Often they seek money. We don't know. Some of them may go to some illegal places. Some of them may chew tobacco. Some of them taking this money, our hard earned money. Taking this money, they may use chew tobacco. They may use smoke cigarette, this thing, bad things they may do. we should not do it. We should not give to them. Because taking our hard-earned money, what will they do? They will go to bad places. They will do bad things. So, we should pay to those persons, those who are deserving. Earlier I told already. Do not delay the payment. Give it time. That means I have promised some person to give something. That means whenever time will come, we have to give in time. We should not make delay. So these things we have to consider. This is the whole concept of Sadaqa and Zakat. And if we do this thing, inshallah, in the day of judgment, we will be rewarded. May Allah give us the ability to do this properly. To give the Zakat, give the Sadaqa in a proper way. Ameen. That's all for today. If you have any question regarding this chapter, you may call me. Inshallah, I shall reply. Assalamu alaikum.